Look, often we talk about the strategies for testing and automation. And when we talk about automation, generally people talk about the front end, the UI part, or the API part. But there is another area where automation can be applied called as test data, and you need proper test data management strategies so that you can utilize it in a better way. So let's see what testers have given the advice about test data management. We are covering this big mind map, which is prepared from testing tips. If you have not seen the other videos, do look at the link that is on the screen. And today's topic is, as you know, test data. So let me jump to it. So the first advice that tester gives is that don't use data like this, right? Just to type fast and without looking at the keyboard, we use this kind of data, ASDF or this lorem ipsum 1 2 3 4 5. So use the production like data, like what could be a particular name, if there is a phone number, if it is 10 digit, so you can try a proper number over there. Or some people even suggest that you use the self-referential data, like by which you can understand things. For example, if you're putting a name, you can write it like name first, right? So then you know that you have entered 20 names, then which is the first one, which is the 20th one. So the data can reference to itself. So that is one advice. And again, this is one of the same advice that don't use any dummy data. Try to have production-like data, but mask it. So, for example, if you are using the name Gaurav Khurana, you can play with some characters, just randomize it so that you can swap few characters so that it does not, somebody cannot take that production data and misuse it, right? If you have some numbers, it is 10 digit over there, just swap 2 3 numbers so that it is not identifiable, but try to get the data from production, right? That is one advice. And how do you manage the test data? So this is a very good advice that you can manage the test data at org level, right? If some data is common across, like suppose for all the projects which are in India region, all the phone numbers would be of 10 digits, especially the mobile numbers, right? Project level could be specific to a region, right? Or a particular project requirement. For example, if a particular project wants their subscriber ID to be start with SU, right? So then it would be project level or a particular team you are working in. So how it will help is it will be a single point of contact, right? Where people can look at the data and they know that, okay, this is the data which is getting tested, which is being used by a developer tester. So everybody can look at it and you will be find less problems because people have agreed to that data and everybody is using that, right? You can have a test data generator, as I said in the starting, that this is a very important area where automation can play a role. You can use any language, Python, Java, or any other scripting language to do this, or even SQL to have the data stored in a database. Right, you can write some stored procedure. So this is also an automation, right? Where you will identify the various data types, like the simple one, integers, where we have floating points like salary and all that stuff. And some would be specific to the project, right? And there could be logical dependencies as well. For example, a phone number present in one table should also be present in another table, right? Suppose you do step-by-step things, then you need dependent data, right? If you added something at step one, same data you should enter at step two, right? If they have a linking between them. So we have to take care of those logical dependency. We can have an infra, right, where this is linked to the first point we shared, where you are storing the data for org project or team level, right? So there should be a mechanism by which people can store it, they can share it, and how they can retrieve it later, right? Different teams can contribute to the same data, so it will save a lot of effort for you, right? And we have to take care of security as well, like so we should use mask data when taking from production. And we can apply that, that we can get the SQL injection data set to avoid that people can't do SQL injection on your application. It's safe from it. Another advisor, right, you can have some API or DB scripts which are called before the tests are run so that the data is ready. to be applied to the test automation suite, right? Or even if you are doing exploratory testing, you can have the data ready in front of you, maybe in the form of Excel sheet or database or the way you like it. And the other advice is you can have a setup and tear down script, like setup by which you will get the data using these mechanism, right? And tear down is so that you know that the data you are living in this same state, right? You are not updating anything over there. So these are some good advice given by testers for the test data. I'll share this mind map. Hope you like it. And if you have any other points which you feel are missing, you can enter it in the comments. And this is my channel, and in the playlist, you can find the testing tips playlist. And this is an easy way to remember it. Hope you like it, and you will subscribe to the channel and press that bell icon to get notified. Thank you.